All right. Well, this isn't a crop update. I'm gonna try to get one of those in here at some point. Probably after the beans finally finish cleaning up here in a week or so. But as you can see, the ragweed is all pretty much dead. It just needs to lay down on the ground now. But this is gonna be a little bit of a weather update, because the weather that we got going on right now reminded me of a good joke that we'll do here at the end of the video. But I don't want to make this too damn long. I just wanted to have something to put up this after tonight. So I really hope these beans start filling in. I don't want to get too hyped up about them yet. Give these things another week or another week, and it's gonna make a big damn difference. But right now they just kind of look bleh. But anyway, so we have completely flipped sides here. We were going from couldn't beg, borrow, and steal rain to, between last weekend up to today, we've had 5 inches. And it's still raining. We just caught it in between storms right now. It's sprinkling. Was it last Saturday and Sunday we got rain? It was the 20th and the 21st. So whatever days those were. Monday, Tuesday, Sunday, Monday. I think it was Sunday, Monday. Whatever the 20th and the 21st were. Between those two, we had 1.5 inches one day and then 3/4 the next. Or 3/4 the first day and 1.5 inches the next. So we got 2.25 then. And today I just got home from work and emptied another 2.25 out of the rain gauge from what we got from last night up until 3:30 this today. And we're supposed to get another somewhere between 3 and 3.5 inches between now and Monday. So we definitely needed the rain. We were hurting, but it could have came like drawn out over like 2-3 weeks instead of getting it in one weekend. We're kind of going, luckily it did come slow. It didn't like all come in an hour. So it's been coming most of the day. So it has been coming slow enough to soak in, but we're at a point now where at least your topsoil has reached its carrying capacity, and now all the wet spots are standing full of water. And there's already been a bunch of, luckily I've been looked all over and I couldn't find any issues that I have personally yet, but a couple of guys I do know have already lost a bunch of beans in the drowned out spots. Corn is tall enough now, it's gonna take it. You have to dump a lot of water before you cook the corn out, but I mean, that's knee high by the 4th of July. I think we smoked that date already, but so yeah, it's gonna be a little wet, and I still gotta get the muck sprayed, which by the time it quits raining and dries out enough to get down there, I think it's going to be too tall for me to get over with my sprayer. So I'm probably going to have my dad, or my buddy's dad, run down there with his Rogator and get over it. I got all the chemical already. I just can't get over it. I am glad that, because I still had about 50 gallon of bean mix left in the sprayer that I put in there, because I knew I was going to have to go back and clean up some skips. And Thursday, Friday so far have been the only 2 days this week that it didn't rain. And I got home Thursday and it was pretty windy. I mean, it was way windier than what I should have been spraying, but I was like, well, I gotta get this damn sprayer emptied out. Otherwise, this spray is gonna start salting out, and I'm gonna have issues, and I need to get the sprayer empty in case I can spray the muck, and just in case it keeps freaking raining, I need to get my skip sprayed, which I had one in this field, which I actually got sprayed last weekend, I think. And I didn't actually have that many, except for that last field I sprayed where I talked about I kept having my tips plug. I had to do probably 3 acres of that. I went over again just to make double damn sure I got everything. But, so Thursday I came home and I was looking at the weather, because yesterday was supposed to be calmer. It was Wednesday. Wednesday and Thursday were the 2 days, because today's Friday. Durka dur. So Wednesday was windier than hell. I decided to say screw it because they kept flip-flopping rain chances in for yesterday. So I got through, got on my skid spray, got the sprayer emptied out, got the sprayer cleaned out. And then yesterday, while I was cleaning the sprayer out, it started dumping rain on us. So I was glad that I went through and got all my skips taken care of Wednesday instead of trying to wait. So I was going to hold off until Thursday because they were talking less wind. Well, it ended up raining, so it would have been not so good. But anyway, so yeah, basically we're wet. Can't spray. Was going to try to work on the 7300 this weekend, but now it's supposed to rain and everybody's shop's full, so I can't work on the 7300, which isn't too big of a deal because now with all this rain, we're probably going to be pushing wheat harvest back a little bit, which is the other thing that this rain's making me nervous about. Is so far, the wheat's been standing pretty good, and as long as we don't get any super heavy rain, we're going to be all right. But if we get a bunch of rain and a bunch of wind all at one time, there's a possibility it could start laying the wheat down, and then my ass is going to be buying crop lifters for the grain table to try to pick that stuff back up. And I really just would like to cut standing wheat and not have to worry about it laying down. So I think this weekend I'm going to go ahead and pull the manure spreader in the shop and see if I can get it knocked out, because probably a day to get all the wood out, get it prepped, and make sure everything's kosher, and then a day to put it back together, I'm assuming. And I got tires for it, and I got tires for the 7300. That was an expensive day yesterday. So yeah, which you'll see the tires and everything here in a later. Teeter, stop eating ragweed. That's gonna make you sick. Yeah, that's gonna make you sick. So yeah, that's what we're gonna be doing this weekend, since we can't really do anything else, is work on the manure spreader, because I can get that in the shop and work on it where it's dry. As long as Dad doesn't have anything going on, but I don't think he does. So yeah, that's basically where we're at. We're wet and we can't really do a whole lot, because we went from way too dry to too damn wet. Not complaining, I'll take the rain. I am glad that I have all my spraying done except for the muck, because the muck, it needs sprayed, but it's not like a life or death. If I can't get it, it's gonna knock my yield down a little bit, because I don't have that manganese on it. But if I can't get it sprayed, I can't get it sprayed. I'd rather not spray it than tear the hell out of the field trying to get it sprayed and get a sprayer stuck and knock down a bunch of corn getting the sprayer unstuck. And yeah, Joey's a farmer muck ground. However, that corn dog there does look damn good. I went and looked at it yesterday. So, but like I say, I'm going to do a crop update here probably in a week or two. Probably about a week. Let things start to catch up now that we're actually getting rains. With some H2O and some heat and some time, it's going to make things look tremendously different, especially in the bean department, because right now the beans look like shit. And I know why they look like shit, and we'll talk about that later too. But anyway, on to the joke. Because, you know, farmers are always complaining about weather. So, there's these two guys sitting at a bar, and they've had a few, and they're getting a little tipsy, and they're sitting there talking to each other, and next thing they know, this lady of the night walks in the bar and sits down next to them, and they're talking to each other, and they keep looking over at her, and she's sitting there smoking a cigarette. She orders a drink, and the guys start kind of talking to her a little bit and getting to know her. And one guy says, "So, in your line of work, what's the worst kind of people you've ever had to deal with?" And she sits there and she thinks for a minute. She goes, "Well, I really don't like having to do doctors, because all they ever want to do is talk about all the lives they've saved and all the surgeries they've done and all the money they've made off of it." She said, "But there's also the lawyers. I really don't like working with them, because all they ever want to do is talk about all the big cases they've won and all the people they've helped with their law degrees and all the money they've made with it. And I can't do that." And she sits there for a minute and they're talking, and she goes, "You know what though? I think the absolute worst people I've ever had to deal with are farmers." He says, because they show up, and first it's too hot, and then it's too dry, or then it's too cold, then it's too dry, then it's too wet. And then they want to find out if they can defer payment until January. And then when it's all said and done, they ask if I can give them a free hat. So that's the joke. Old guy in town here told me that one day. And it's been funny ever since. So anyway, that's your quick Friday weather update for our little corner of heaven right here. So I guess I'm going to go ahead and get this video edited real quick. Not that there's gonna be a whole lot of editing to it, and get it uploading, and go ahead and get the manure spreader, get down here, bring it in the shop, and start working on that. So that's it for this one. I'll catch you guys on the next one. Teeter. Say bye. Say bye. Say bye.